It was a good day for Herve, son of absent father and nameless mother in the town of Pallet, residence of Kanto, southwestern region. It was an important day because today was the day that Herve could finally begin his Pokemon journey. And as he prepared to depart his room on this most glorious of days, he knew that whatever adventures awaited him beyond the bounds of Route 1 would bring him to greatness. Well, he hoped. He wasn't usually that confident. Pallet Town consisted of three residences. There was Herve's own house. There was his neighbor and rival Quinn's house. And there was the lab of Quinn's grandfather, Professor Oak. But today, Herve chose not to go in any of these residences. Instead, he chose to be suicidal. But Oak had other plans for Herve. Much more important plans. Herve had made the radical assumption that he could just leave his city without any sort of protection, any sort of guidance. But Herve was wrong. Herve's rival and former childhood friend Quinn was an interesting figure. He presumed that his position as grandson of the world's premier Pokemon scientist granted him the license to do as he pleased, when he wanted, where he wanted, and how he wanted. In fact, the only person who ever denied him this right was Herve himself. And it was on this day that the two would choose their first Pokemon, that the rivalry that had been brewing since their childhood would finally cement itself. Herve was to pick first. He thought carefully. Maybe the one on the right. I like the right. Ooh, fire, he thought. Fire. It reminded him of the Bon Jovi song, Blaze of Glory. And that was when he knew instantly what he needed to name this new denizen of his life. It was quite obvious, really. A name sent from the heavens. Okay, maybe it wasn't obvious right away, but it was obvious pretty close enough. Alright, come on, Herve, let it be obvious. There you go. In light of the song Blaze of Glory, there could be only one name for this majestic creature. And his name would be the one and only Con Bon Jovi. And then, of course, Quinn decided to screw everything up by picking the one Pokemon on Earth that could probably destroy Con Bon Jovi, just because he was an idiotic troll face. But this matchup would soon be put to the test through Herve's first Pokemon battle.
It feels like the very first time. It feels like the
Thank you, Daughtry, for that inspiring cover of a Foreigner song. And so Quinn departed, shown what Herve was made of. But now it was time for Herve to leave too. To leave the house that he had spent years of his life in. To leave behind the five people who lived in his small little hamlet. But before he could leave, he had work to do. Because no good Pokemon trainer went into the field blind. He checked Con Bon Jovi's statistics. Through a summary device that somehow existed. No need to break the fourth wall or anything here. But how is it that Herve can just automatically tell what these baseline statistics needed to raise a Pokemon are? Does he have a device? He doesn't get his Pokedex until next episode. But I digress. Herve's journey was about to begin. The greatest journey in the history of mankind. And I, for one, am excited to see where it leads. $3,080! That's more than I've made in my life. Oh, God. Alright. This has been The Adventures of Herve. Signing off. I believe we're signing off. Are we signing off? Oh dear God. Oh dear God. Yes, we're signing off. Goodbye.